3-1 overall. Minnesota took a tight contest in 2015 by a score of 135-127.
So the action is about to get underway here. Jamie Harris for the Minnesota Golden Girls, Minnesota Knights, is number 98 by Holder there. And she is facing off against number 1-4-1-3.
Jackets on the way, both skaters trying to fight their way through some very strong passes in the upset. And a time over there starts to become a new champ of the world of Minnesota Knights.
Thank you. And
Miami Bloodlust looking to add to that total as we are about to be 12 jams deep. And neither team has reached 20 points. Who's definitely on the line for the Minnesota Knights as well. Miami looks right inside and has it. That is Wayne Jennerman.
It's now 29 to 25.
Litigation, intellectual property,
Jamie Cutlass, the Melinda second wave in black hair, and the blue, Nova Chiba, the one that makes look at some nice. Both jammers really, really good. All of our skaters are certainly skating in the crowd. Pay attention to these jammers, how it's never wasted. It comes to fruition there for Bambi Cutlass.
Thank you.
second round has actually been able to win the jam on points.
So amazing.
Back on the track, so more jammers in play here. Kate Destroy with a nice block, forceful race cycle. Isabel able to make her way to the back. We'll see if there are any points going there. No, said the referee. And one on the board, Minnesota Nice.
So Minnesota Nice trying to shoot into that lead that the second win had built up. We have a minute 20 left to go in this first half, and this is where we'll remind you that the jam will supersede the game clock. So even if the game clock takes down zero, so open that jam clock on the right. Heavy Bloodlust facing off against
Recycle Force there off of a nice head of the table now. And Heavy Bloodlust out the main jammer. Both teams have reached. Oh, streak going against Oma Achieva.
Star pass for the Minnesota Knights. The jammer of the record now, Ben, and they stop it.
Isabel back on the track, for the second win, and tiptoes her way on the sidelines and get to the back.
Isabel now out. High bond issue.
There was a ghost point in the box, so passing one gets you two.
Saw the referee signal waiting to see if that was confirmed at the table. It was.
So score now 109 for the second win, 86 for the Minnesota. Oh, go ahead. Yes, we're still talking about things. So we're going to take an official timeout.
Thought there might be some more discussion on that score.
So during this official timeout, we'd like to thank Joanna Marcus and Body of War. Joanna Marcus and Body of War is a proud sponsor of the Windy City Rollers. Joanna Marcus is a massage therapist who specializes in therapeutic plant-based body work that is primarily influenced by Thai massage. Her treatments will leave you in an alert, calm, and resourceful state of mind. For more information and to make an appointment, visit www.joannabodywork.com.
Also, one of our speaker sponsors, but she is still allowed to sponsor the third coast of the Lombard Show. Pronounced Pushing the Steel, which is a given for a good shot at the stop of the Irish Bunch of the Park, providing a fine range of community experience. Pushing the Steel also features a cool, a jukebox to get down to, and TVs to watch your favorites and play games. Come visit Pushing the Steel at 1502 West Charles Avenue in the Rogers Park.
And don't forget about the after party, where everybody wins. It's at Carrie's Lounge, a proud sponsor of Christian Manuel. Christian Carrie's Lounge is your friendly local neighborhood tap catering to all your drinking needs since 1972. In addition to the wine selection of beers and spirits, Carrie's features a wide wine and a badass selection of pitcher packs. Come and visit them at 2251 West Devon.
An extra point added to the board after that official timeout, so our score now stands at 101-87. That is 7-1 for Minnesota Nice. Paul Licious for the examiner for the second win. Coach on this time is the lead.
Thank you.
from Minnesota now knocking on the door of the century mark. Having a dead lead at the second win, a 21 point difference between these two. Because I can back. Yeah, look at that. That's good. That's good. All right, at Trixie, jamming for the second win, facing off against my polar bear. Minnesota Knights.
Has been held down since that 9-point jam by Alicious. That chances of winning, and now she is the lead jammer once again. We've got a nice win race out here at the dark, folks. Both packs looking to arrange themselves as such. That chances is super good. All about the jam with 4 points on the board. That, folks, is called a hit it and call it.
ChicagoWomen'sFunnyFestival.com.
As also, we want to thank PMP Mill Company, a proud sponsor of Millennium City Rollers, with capabilities ranging in commercial builds, photography, and website design. PMP Mill Company is a global for service creative agency that will strategize, conceptualize, and tell your brand story. For more information, visit them online at www.empmillco.com.
And once again, we would like to thank our medics, Mama and Papa Doc, who have been with the Windy City Rollers, well, forever. So a huge thank you for Mom to Mama and Papa Doc for keeping everybody safe and healthy today. Baby Bloodlust facing off against
breakthrough, and there is a lot more
21 points per jam. And it kind of finished out that way in the first half. So they're only able to tell the 50 points on the scoreboard. However, this half, they were able to really knock down the door, taking advantage of some power jams and some lapses by the second win. And it brought us back to a 20-point game.
They really bounced back in that after having a couple of jams in this half. Minnesota Knights has really pumped through and made this a very contentious game. With only 20 points separating these two teams, that's a matter of a jam. We saw that a few times in the previous game. We had multiple more than 20 jams going on. So we'll see what happens here as our official review has come to an end.
Minnesota was requested that the clockwise blocking penalty call on by the ball was upgraded to an expulsion. The call on the track stood as called. Number 504 stays in play. Minnesota loses their official review.
The power chair has been 3:10 left to go. 7 points between these two teams.
Time out taking three on the second win is Abby Wilson, who are on the track to discuss strategy here with Ed Tracy. I said on that last champion that the clock is a bit of a factor, and it is. But it's even who is behind on points and now the second win, staring at that 7-point deficit, the first deficit they faced here in the second half. Now they have to adjust accordingly. See what they can do is give us some nice play of the Wilson Grand Slams here in the second half. And they will force the jam penalties. And that's the way they're going to win this game back.
And the second win has the advantage in that this is the first timeout. They still have an additional time, two timeouts, and their official review. So they have all the control of the clock in the world that they could possibly want. So they're really in an advantageous position to execute some five.
Come on!
I don't think anybody's out of the parking lot yet, anybody.